I've already prepared some feature groups. That's the tool to get a little bit more structure into my model tree. First, I want to go with the planes. So let's start. I need parallel to that plane. First one should be a 10 millimeter. Apply. Next one should be at 20 millimeter. Apply. Next one should be at 40. Apply. Next one is at 120. Apply. Another one at 123. Apply. One at 887. Apply. One at 190. Apply. One at, let's say, 275. One at 277. One at 281. One at 283. And then last one at 300. Okay, all those planes should be in the feature group reference plane, so just move it over there. Now the sketches, it's easier to draw the sketches than to copy them and change the value. So I will start with a sketch on that plane. Yes, this will be a circle. Diameter should be 60. Finish that sketch. Next sketch on that plane right here. Okay. Circle with diameter 10. Finish that sketch. Next sketch on this plane. Circle with diameter 80. Finish that sketch. Next one, just go for circle and select the plane, but I didn't snap onto that point, so go sketch, select the plane, okay, draw a circle, and that circle would have a diameter of 70 maybe. Finish that sketch. Yeah, this looks good. Next sketch on this plane. Circle with diameter 80. Finish. Another sketch on that plane. Diameter of that circle should be 7, 8. Finish that sketch. Let's take a look. So this didn't quite work, so selected 7, 8. 7, 8. What's this? That sketch? That's not 7, 8. That's crazy. Okay, go inside that sketch. Yeah, because I snapped onto something. So let's remove that constraint right here. Finish sketch. Next sketch on this plane. Another circle. Diameter is 78 again. Finish that sketch. Next sketch on this plane. Circle with 80 diameter. Finish that sketch. Now let's go up to this plane. Sketch that plane right here. That's a circle with 30 millimeter diameter. Finish that sketch. Next sketch on this plane. Circle with 40 diameter. Finish. Let's take a look. Sketch on this plane. Again, a circle with 40 diameter. Finish it. Sketch on that one. Diameter should be 30. Finish it. And the last one at the top plane. Sketch. Select the plane. Okay. Another circle. The diameter would be 30. As well. Finish that sketch. Similar to Cartier, I could try to do it with a through curves surface. So let's try this one out. Through curves, select this one. Then this one. Switch to sheet. Next would be that one. This one. That one. This one. And this looks pretty good. In comparison to the Cartier multi-section solid, which I just did, this looks pretty good. Because if you remember in Cartier, it went like this. So that's almost the correct bottle. If you would change the boundary angles, you could almost have the bottle. Okay, but I want to do it in a different way. That's just for interest. So let's move the sketches into their feature groups. So let's minimize this one. The first sketch should be in the bottom section. The next sketch should be in the bottom section. This sketch as well. So there should be now three sketches, yes. Then that sketch should be in the bottom section as well. Or maybe in the lower section. The next two sketches should be, one should be it in the lower section. And this one should be in the midsection. Next one in the midsection. Next one could be in the midsection or in the upper section, not in the upper. Sorry, I will correct this. This would be in the upper section. That sketch would be would be in the thread section. This sketch would be in the thread section. This one and that one as well. And that sketch should be in the thread section as well. Just to lower section, it's only one. Maybe I should move this one to the lower section as well. Yeah, okay, I will move this to the lower section as well. Midsection, midsection. Yeah, that's okay. Now, where do I start? I can do the extrudes first. So let's go for an extrude with this one. That sketch right here. That should be zero. And it should end until selected. And the selected element would be this plane. And I want to have, of course, not a solid, but a sheet. Okay? And that should be in the thread section group. Another extrude would be this one. So go for another extrude from that sketch. Again, I want to have a sheet, and this should go up to until selected, up to that plane right here. And okay. And move this one to the midsection. Of course, there's another extrude right there. So select that sketch, make another extrude, again go for a sheet, and again make it until selected, and the selected plane would be this one. Okay. And move this one to the threat group right here. Now let's take a look. I need a sketch on the YZ plane, so go for sketch, select the YZ plane, this one, okay. Let's begin at the top. I need those intersection points, so let's check. There are intersection points, and there you go, intersection point between the sketch plane and that one. Apply, and between this curve and OK. Now I need a spline with at least 3 points. So go to, where's my spline? Studio spline, 3 points, yes, and this should start right here, then go maybe there, and another one right on this point. And apply. So let's move this a little bit. Cancel this out, and you can adjust that spline, maybe like this. And this should maybe go in set direction, but it's not necessary. Okay, well, let's select this one. That's okay. Yeah, that's okay. Finish that sketch and make a revolve. So go to revolve. I want to revolve that curve around the set axis, and it should be 360 degrees, and it should be a sheet. Okay. Now let's move these two elements in their feature group. That would be the upper section. So this one, that sketch, and that revolve should be in the upper section. And let's try to change that name to upper, not upsa. Nice. Then another sketch on the same plane as before. Okay. Again, I need those intersection points. So let's go for intersection point. I need this intersection point. Apply that one. Apply. And that one. Apply. Cancel this out. And that would be a spline with at least 4 points. This one starts right here, goes up to this one. And then maybe like this, and then up to that one. Okay. Now let's edit this a little bit. Yeah, and maybe a construction line, or yeah, select that axis and that spline right here. And I want to edit this one. So in that point, I want it to be tangent. And the tangent should be the Y Z direction. And okay. Maybe like this. Yeah, that's okay. Now finish that sketch, make another revolve, make it a sheet, select the curve, and the vector would be this axis. Okay. So let's go, before I do another sketch, and check those points, if those splines are really on that point, and this doesn't seem like it. So let's go to sketch 13 and check this out. So these 2 points should be this point and that point right here of the spline should be coincident. Finish that sketch, and the same up here. So just zoom in, and this seems to be not really the case. Maybe that's just the accuracy. So let's check this out. Go to that sketch. Sketch this sketch right here. That sketch and those 2 points should be aligned. That's sketch number 13. Go inside that sketch and check this one out. So this point right here and that point, the intersection point and that spline point, should be coincident. Finish that sketch. Okay, you have to make sure that these are coincident, otherwise you will get problems afterwards. So again here, there's, I didn't snap on it. Let's zoom in, select that intersection point and that spline point, and make them coincident. Same at the bottom, this one, the intersection point and that one, the spline start point should be coincident. Finish that sketch. So this is more like it. Okay, next sketch on the YZ plane. Okay, and again I need those intersection points, so I might hide this one, and that would be sketch 36. Hide the complete sketch. Yeah, because I need a new intersection point for that sketch. So go to, where is it, intersection point from that curve and from this one. Now let's go for a spline point, point, and okay. Now let's put those points coincident, this one and that one, and this one, and that one. That's okay. Could align this to that one and I think I did it parallel to the Z axis, so we'll do it the same here, and that should be aligned to that axis. So let's select this one, go to that point, and this would be the exact, yes, and this point right here should be tangent to the, I think it's the Y set, let's take a look, yes, and okay. Just move the points a little bit and adjust that. And I could align it to that curve. Yeah, it doesn't matter. I will do it like this. That's okay with me. Maybe like this. Okay. Finish that sketch. And make another revolve with that sketch, and the vector would be the Z axis, and go for another sheet and okay. Move those elements into the bottom feature group, bottom section feature group, yes. Let's take a look. There you could go with a fill or a bounded plane. Okay, so let's go for a bounded plane. That would be a surface. Let's take a look. Bounded plane with that circle, and you got, it's almost like a fill. Move this to the bottom section feature group. Now I wander through curves. From this curve and that face right here to that curve and that face tangent, and okay. And of course you should go for a sheet and not a solid. Okay. Up here, I want to try the same again through curves. So make it tangent. So this curve right here, sketch with that face, and add another curve that would be this one with this face. This looks okay. If you want to do the same here, that's kind of a problem because you see this goes is bent in that direction, so I will not get around to that one. And my workaround here would be I will make another plane and another sketch, a smaller circle, so I can force that through curves into the right direction. So just move that through curves to the bottom and the last through curves to the thread section. Where's my thread section? It's up here. Right there. Okay. Then need another plane. And that plane should have a distance from that one of 1 millimeter distance. Okay, move this plane up there. That's okay. And I need a sketch on that plane. This will be a circle. And diameter might be 33, for example, 35, here 33, 35, here 35, make it 35. Finish that sketch. And now if I make it through curves, I can force it to bend around. Yeah, maybe this should be not 35, but 32. Okay, go through curves, select that sketch, the face would be this one, then add another circle, that one, and right now, see that looks good, now I could add the last circle right here. And make it tangent to that face. And of course, make it a sheet. Okay? And so my basic bottle is modeled. So that's for this part of the PET bottle. Hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook cat fan page and like it, please. Would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one, the second part. Bye bye.